Minehead Station was built in 1874, giving day trippers from London direct access to this seaside town, overlooking the banks of the Bristol Channel. Almost 150 years later, it's a perfectly preserved tourist attraction, thanks to the West Somerset Railway, who maintain a fully operational railway. With 10 stations, a huge collection of diesel and steam locomotives, carriages, wagons, and every item of railway honour imaginable. Their chairman is Jonathan Jones Pratt.
We're the longest preserved railway in the UK, and we've got 22 miles. We operate from Bishop's Lydia to Minehead. We've invited Drew here today because the railway's got plenty of kit, as in such as signs, a lot of relics and things, so we're really confident that we're going to find something here for him today. We are a heavily volunteer-based organisation, and you know, the railway's an expensive animal to operate, so we're very fortunate to have Drew here today, and you know, looking forward to hopefully gaining some support for him for the West Somerset.
Ooh! Are these for me to look at?
There's some that we pulled out, yeah. We thought you might like them.
These are great. T, would you like some Will's Superfine Shag?
Yes, please.
I thought you would.
I'll have an ounce of that, please.
Would you?
Yeah.
Puritan soap is pure soap. I do like the India Tires one as well.
Dating from the 1920s, the designs on these vitreous enamelled signs were made by using heat to fuse a coloured glass coating onto a metallic base. The result is a smooth but incredibly tough surface that never fades. The non-enamelled backing of these signs have succumbed to the elements in places, creating wear and tear that adds to their aesthetic appeal. They could be worth around £300 each.
Puritan soap's a bit knackered, and I think that one there would be, I was going to say 65 quid, but as it's used, as it's this, 75 quid.
Okay.
For that one. I think the Wills one would be £100.
Right.
That one would be one price only for that one, which would be 150.
Okay.
So that'd be 225 plus whatever I sold on the 325 for all.
You go up at all a bit? It's for a good cause, you see this.
You're not meant to laugh. You're not meant to be on my side.
This is just a bit I enjoy. It's funny.
350, let's have it done.
350.
Deal?
OK, deal.
Marvellous. Yeah. Right, excellent. Next place, please.
Is that on the top there, Drew?
Watch your head.
What's on it?
Just making sure there wasn't all loads of... Oh, that's great, isn't it?
Mm.
Pub signs with illustrations to indicate drink, food and lodging have been in use since the 12th century and were originally a necessity, as the majority of the medieval population couldn't read or write. This one for the Courage Brewery can be dated to the early 20th century, as they acquired the Alton Brewery in 1903. Finished in fantastic contrasting colours and with the famous cockerel in the centre, it could be worth around £350.
120.
That's probably worth a bit more, that one.
It is. I'm trying to make some extra bit of profit because I've lost on these ones here.
Yeah, that's worth more, that one.
OK. Did you say you used to be a farmer, or you are a farmer?
Live on a farm, yeah. Yeah, I've got farming in the blood. But yeah.
Damn. Whenever you deal with farmers, you never get anything for a good price. 150, and that's it, done. You're not getting another penny.
Do 160 on that.
Really? Another tenner?
I had 200
in my
head.
You can take your tractor outside, have you?
Yeah, I had 200 in my head.
God almighty.
Yeah.
160.
Yeah.
Are we done?
Done.
Deal.
Deal.
Right.
Cheers.
Go on then. Right. Let's get out of here before I lose any more money. Blimey. You can always tell a farmer they're always really good at doing deals. And he's knocked me up every single time on all these. And I paid too much for everything. So I start him low and we end up at 160. Fine. I'd have paid it anyway. So that's fine. But I know what he's doing. He's very, very good at it. But, you know, we're here to make money as well.
Right, so we've got these containers that are full up with all sorts.
Oof, big, dirty, oily things.
Mm.
You normally like them.
I do like them. I'll tell you what I do like. This. That's cool.
Yeah.
Can you sell that?
Well, it might do, depends on the number.
Right, well, I know two things now. One, you're not backward and coming forward. and you've got a bit of farmer in you, so you'll have to start giving me prices.
Oh, really?
Now on.
Yeah. Doing it that way.
Yeah,
now,
we're switching sides now.
That's the plan, is it?
Yeah, so give us a price on that then. And you've got all these as well. Oh, hello, and that.
Yeah, the rack, you can have a look at as well.
This would definitely.
You interested in these car plates, in?
Yeah. So is that the number of the train?
Yes.
So that's train number 5,000.
Yeah, they're off of a castle there.
Hey! Yeah. There you go. How's about that then?
Go in the kitchen, that would.
That would go in the kitchen.
This painted, galvanised steel rack was made in the 1950s and would have been used in a station ticket office for incoming post. The three shelves over 10 pigeonholes design makes it ideal for repurposing as a storage unit. A guaranteed seller for Drew, with just a light clean, it could be worth around £250.
That's 50 quid, grab you.
What's that for?
That.
50 quid, what deal are you going to do on the...
You can come on now.
Yeah. Well, these we'd want 300 quid each for.
Righto, and the Exmoor one?
And the 300 for that as well.
I'll leave those.
Yeah.
I'd like to have a look, better look at the Exmoor one. Have we got a deal on this one? Because I'm not going to pay any more money for that one. I'm not paying a penny more for that, so that's take it or leave
it. Take that, yeah.
Fine.
Go on.
Thank you.
That's that.
Exmoor. Any history?
It's been here for some time, so it's, you know, it's a known plate here.
Has it got any age to it?
No. It's one of the newer style plates.
It's the newer ones.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
This steam engine nameplate used to be mounted on one of the West Somerset Railway's locomotives. Although a reproduction from the late 20th century, it's made from brass like the original and features a furled ribbon design. A superb and authentic railway collectible with ties to the local area of natural beauty famed for its Exmoor ponies. It could be worth around £500.
For 300 you could have it for a bargain.
I could have it for 300 quid. I don't want to pay 300 quid for it, to be honest.
But that is, it's worth that all day long.
Well, yeah, but that's no good to me because I need to profit, don't I?
Well, yeah, but you'll make something on that as well. Talented man, aren't you?
You are good, aren't you, John? Let's have a deal at 200 quid.
200?
Yeah.
I should have asked more money for the rack now.
Well, you didn't.
Yeah.
And you said. You had me over on the signs. Yeah.
250.
No.
To meet halfway.
No, I've got no.
That's why you came at 200. You came at 200 to meet halfway.
Usually,
halfway.
Yes.
Halfway.
Let's have a deal at 200 quid.
We'll see how the other two containers go on, and then we'll come back.
So you're turning down 200 quid. You can walk out. I'm going to walk.
250.
No. 200 quid. I paid too much. We've got to level things out.
Yeah.
I was happy at 300 quid. I see it more at 500 quid. To be honest with you. But I've got to win sooner or later, so I just say, no, all right, we'll leave it then. I know that always works. It always bothers people. If they get an offer and they go, all right, leave it, it's the best thing you can do is just walk away.
Have a look in here.
Ooh. Oh, blimey, look at that. Oh, my word.
Got those oil pots and things and wondering about these lamps or something.
No.
You like lamps?
No, right? At least once every couple of days, we're offered a pair of them.
Yeah.
Paul stripped and polished and waxed within each other. They're like, they're not really for me.
Okay.
Nope. Next one, please.
Next one.
Yeah.
I think you've been through them all now, haven't you?
Have we?
Yeah.
So we just need to discuss that you're overpriced. Sorry, your pricing.
I knew you'd come back to it.
Come on, let's just have it for 200 quid.
250.
225, and let's leave it as friends.
225, okay.
Deal.
Deal.
Let's go. I'm having it. Thank you. We go in another couple of containers. There's nothing really for me to get hold of. Come back, 225. We do a deal on the Exmoor sign. Happy days. Happy days. Now, I can now sell that for 400 quid really quick, or 500 quid after a couple of weeks. But I reckon I can get 400 quid like that and trade it out today. John is, I found out, a very clever man. He's also quite a good lad at doing deals as well. Not quite as good as me, and I did get one over on him and he got three over on me. Yeah, he's better than me at doing it. Yeah,
I feel quite chuffed. I think we've had him in the many ways on some of the deals, so it's a good result all round. We're continually fundraising. We need money, we need support, trying to keep our railway alive, so this has been great. We're blessed that the boys came down, so pleased that they did.